New boyfriend is a radio star like Jack Benny or Tommy Handley. His name is Jeffrey Metcalf. I'm sending a photograph so you can see for yourself how smashing he is. Jeffrey had planned on a career as a baseball player, but injured his leg and was told he could not play professionally. Rather than cry over spilt milk, he set out to make his career in radio. He's very ambitious, unlike someone I could mention who promised me the moon and then walked out on me. But the less said about that, the better. I'm sending $10 for you and $2 to get Patricia something for her birthday. I love you, Mom. I miss you both.
The Ypsilanti Yodeler is rescheduled for 8:45 without the cat. Put the cat in your car and keep it there, Mr. Vargo. The Bohemian violins will go on after the hour. 2 minutes, Mr. Metcalf.
Thank you, Miss Westcott.
Oh, what a blessing it would be if everyone were as calm as you before a performance. What is your secret?
No secret. I stand where they tell me to stand, say what they tell me to say, pick up my paycheck and go home. Anybody can do it, Miss Westcott. You should give it a try.
Oh, I would be embarrassed to tears in front of a microphone.
Pretend it's not there.
But what about all those people out there in the audience? Nobody realizes it, Mr. Metcalf, but at heart I'm a very shy person.
You could have fooled me, Miss Westcott.
Because I've developed a professional demeanor to hide it. I'm not by nature as stern and officious as I pretend to be.
You can pretend just as successfully on the radio. I pretend I'm talking to my mother, who's always listening at home when she's not here in the audience.
How very sweet. But my dear mother, may she rest in peace, has gone on to her final reward, and I would never be able to erase all those other radios from my mind.
I am sorry about your mother. As for the radios, I never think about them.
Why, there's a radio in every home in this country, Mr. Metcalf. Sometimes two. And a lot of times a third one down in the basement or out in the garage. And one in every store and office. Just imagine how many in all those skyscrapers. And one in every diner and beauty parlor and gas station and fire station. And nowadays in so many cars, I bet you have one in yours.
Let's have a hearty welcome for Jeff Metcalf. Fancy meeting you here, Jeff. Say, how about the weather we've been having lately? Cold, isn't it? I'll say it's cold. Why, it's been so cold, Farmer Jones says when he milks his cows, instead of milk, he gets ice cream. And what do you do when it gets this cold? Why, I expect it's the very same thing that I do. It's what we all do. It's what everybody everywhere with an ounce of sense does, which is heat a can of lemon tomato juice in a saucepan on the stove, pour it into a couple of mugs for my honey and me, that is your honey and you, and warm your feet up by the fire till we're toasty warm. That's what you do on a cold winter night, because...
Lemon tomato juice is all the rave, because it is what we crave.
For you too.
Lemon tomato juice is the best.
You got to act sense. You ate the positive, eliminate the negative, and latch on to the affirmative. Don't mess with Mr. In-Between. You gotta spread joy up to the maximum. Bring gloom down to the minimum. Have faith or pandemonium liable to walk upon the scene. To illustrate my last remark,
Joe in the way, no way in the art.
What did they do just when everything looks so dark? Ma'am, they said you got to accent.
You ain't the positive evil. Mine ain't the negative, and last time to be affirmative,
don't mess with Mr. In Between. No, don't mess with Mr. In Between. No, don't mess with Mr. In Between. No, don't mess with Mr. In Between.
much for listening.
Thank you for covering for
I did it for me. I need this job. And from what I hear about your baseball career and your mother's hospital bills, you need this job.
My leg will be good as new by spring training. I didn't do this on purpose.
Next time, stare at the script. Sometimes that helps.
Okay.
Nick, I could rehearse with you, give you a few pointers.
I would appreciate that.
When?
How about now?
Hi, Jeff.
Hi.
You better get out of that costume. We're going to be late.
Sure. So we'll make a set up an appointment.
Fine.
Fine.
Next time, Slugger, just stare at the script and read.
Worked for me.
Oh. Thanks for the advice.
That's one heck of a salary they're offering.
It is indeed. But you should know, I've already told them you have my highest personal recommendation.
We sail from Havana on the 15th. We could arrive a few days early if it suited you and tour the city. And the entire voyage would last 8 weeks.
It is very generous of you to offer this for me.
Thank you, sir, but I'd have to move to California if I took this job.
My word, if I were your age, I'd jump at the chance to go west, young man, to the Golden State.
I don't know anybody there.
Well, you'd be doing me a favor. Michael can't come along. And I'd relish having a traveling companion, I know. There's nothing worse than talking to a stranger for 8 weeks. Ooh, and we'd be at the captain's table in the dining room.
I didn't know a soul in this area when I moved here. That's part of the excitement, meeting new friends. And I can personally vouch for these people. They are friends. Their integrity is beyond question. Mr. Haley. Charlie. Where are you going to get a salary offer like that around these parts?
Well, you're very kind, sir, but I promised myself if I survived combat, if I ever made it back here in one piece, I'd never leave again.
Thank you very much, but I do not wish to make this voyage.
You don't?
I do not want to be away from Charlie for such a long time. Eventually, I would like to take the speedboat. Maybe for our honeymoon.
It was a good plan. It still is. If we could get them separated for even a few weeks, I'm sure the romance would cool out of sight.
Out of mind. It was a good plan. But it was too logical. These youngsters are anything but logical. Gina, in fact, has a contrary streak.
Now you mention it, she does.
Well, I'll say she does. Time and again, she disagrees with me simply for the sake of disagreeing.
Let's use her contrariness against her. I should have thought of this sooner and suggested it to you. She knows we're not wild about Charlie.
Not wild.
And that, to a person with her contrary nature, is like telling a child not to eat too many cookies before dinner. She may not even have wanted cookies, but when the idea was put in her head, she has to have those cookies.
So, you want to tell her what?
I want to tell her how much we admire and respect her fiancé. What a wonderful idea their engagement is. What a happy marriage they're going to have. She'll be riddled with doubts about the whole affair and drop him like a hot potato.
Oh, would that we could guarantee it.
Well, what other options have we?
I suppose this means we have to have them over for dinner.
I don't know about you, Jeff, but I'm looking forward to spring when those Lemo tomato seeds are planted to grow the best tomatoes money can buy.
Good thing Lemo tomato juice is fresh even in winter, because if this cold spell lasts much longer, we'll be marching in the Easter parade right on top of Lake Erie, because it'll be frozen over.
Perfect. See, you can do it.
It wasn't perfect. I said frozen over. It says here frozen solid. But, and it'll get a lot worse when there's an audience in those seats.
It won't. Your original idea was the best idea. You're talking to your mother, no one else. You just pretend that you're at home in your mother's kitchen reading the lines to her. Don't even think about the millions. Don't even think about anything else.
Millions.
Think about your mother's kitchen. What do you do out at the stadium?
But it's not the same.
Well, it is, Jeff. How do you concentrate when 80,000 fans are watching and you could make an error?
I have made a couple of errors.
But you keep playing.
Well, of course.
If you can do it at the stadium, you can do it here.
Yeah. It helps if you hold your script up here. It keeps you looking up and throat open.
The technical part isn't my problem. I can't get all these radios out of my mind.
But you managed to do it with the fans at the stadium. I have an idea. Don't think about hot dogs and sauerkraut. What are you thinking about?
Hot dogs and sauerkraut.
So, don't think about your mother in the kitchen. Put the thought of your mother in the kitchen completely out of your mind. Banish the thought of your mother in the kitchen.
Well, it works, Sora. Would you like to get a cup of coffee?
Well, I promised Arthur I'd meet him for a cup of coffee after we were finished. You could join us.
No, I've got some stuff to do.
I guess, we're finished.
I guess we're finished. Thanks.
On the wireless tonight. You were quite wonderful.
Yeah, that's very kind of you to say so, but it was pretty obvious I had a bad case of stage fright.
I never noticed.
Well, if you didn't, you're the only person who didn't, which makes you one in a million, literally.
I've been called worse.
I don't mean to ride you. I've been down in the dumps, so.
I know a sure cure for stage fright.
What is it?
As I understand it, stage fright comes from feeling too much tension. A night on the town will relieve a little of that tension.
That sounds like a pretty painless cure. Would you like to have a night on the town with me?
I'd love to.
Here's the grocery money. And here's this month's rent.
Thanks, honey.
Let's get a move on. Therapy session in a half an hour. Did you know that yesterday this remarkable woman moved her leg in the bath?
Congratulations. I'll help you down the stairs.
Don't you want to hear my letter first?
Sure, okay.
On the way out.
Dear Mr. Lemo, I'm also sending one to the station manager. The young ball player who represents your product on the Lemo Tomato Juice Hour is certainly a breath of fresh air.
Mom.
He is wholesome and sweet, polite and funny, too. He gives a good name to your product, which my family drinks almost every day. Sincerely, Mrs. Ann Kahn. With my new married name, they'll never know that I'm your mother. And your Aunt Irene and Palmer promised to send one, too. And Mrs. Senef has already sent two, one using her maiden name.
Thanks.
I am so proud of you, honey. A lot of other men would have gotten discouraged by having to change careers.
I haven't given up on baseball yet. And this radio business isn't all it's cracked up to be.
You're only discouraged because you had a little bout of stage fright. Take some advice from your mom.
Mom?
Hear me out. Stage fright comes from tension. You need to find a way to relieve some of that tension, that's all.
Well, thank you. I guarantee I will do my best to take your advice.
I think I would finish the rest by Thursday.
Oh, swell, Gina. Thanks a million.
No, thank you 1 million for the business. You have chosen a very pretty pattern.
Well, it's like one I used to wear that was someone's favorite.
There is reason maybe to wear someone's favorite outfit again?
Maybe.
I am very happy for you. Jeff is so sweet a person, and always I am thinking to myself, eventually Ginger and Jeff will get back together again. And live happily ever after.
Happily ever after?
I learned this from Emma's books.
Well, maybe it'll happen sooner than eventually. Good night.
Good night. I see you Thursday.
I'm ready, Jeff. Sorry to keep you waiting.
That's okay.
Oh, Gina, one more thing.
Yes?
You said Thursday?
Yes. Thursday's fine.
Absolutely fine. Thanks again.
wonderful time, thanks.
So did I. Could I trouble you for a cup of tea?
I've never met a tea-drinking Yank.
I've never had a cup of tea in my life before, but I believe there's a first time for everything, and if I am going to have my first cup, who better to brew it for me?
If you built this up in your mind, I'm afraid I'll disappoint you.
I wouldn't worry about that.
Well, I think it's only fair to warn you. I love your country, but there are some things we British do differently. Making tea is one of them.
Now, I'm keenly interested in cultural differences.
First you warm the pot. I keep the milk on the window ledge. I don't have a frigid air.
Why do we need to heat a whole pot?
You mean why not use those awful little sacks you Americans tie your tea up in?
What other kind of tea is there?
Loose. Takes a little longer to brew, but the ritual is very nice.
Well, I enjoy learning different ways of doing things.
You're so broad-minded.
What's the extra pot of hot water for?
We keep it nearby to dilute the tea if it's too strong, or warm it up if ever it cools down.
Well, I don't think I'll need it, but it's reassuring to know that it's there. But wouldn't tea bags make things a lot easier instead of all this rigmarole?
Easier is not necessarily better. And many people believe that the tea leaves that manage to get through the strainer and lie in the bottom of your cup tell your future.
And what do I have to look forward to?
I'm not a professional fortune teller, but I think it's safe to say that the immediate future is very promising.
I wish it were.
Need change?
No, I got plenty of change.
Anybody who hates to make a call like you hate to make this call must be calling his dentist.
Worse. Long distance operator, please. Brooklyn, New York. Maine, 4706. Hello, Dad. It's me. Hello, Mrs. Rosen. Well, I haven't heard your voice in a while either. I call when I can. I'll try and call more often. Thank you. Goodbye, Mrs. Rosen. Yeah, I would call more often if she wasn't on your party line. How are you, Dan? Yes, I know how much this long distance cost. I just paid. I could write a letter, but instead I'm calling. What's painful about a phone call? Well, don't sit on... What's wrong with your back? Well, did you see Dr. Mitz? Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't know. But you can still go to... Yes, Olive Ashalom. You can go to a doctor who's still alive. Well, if it's not that serious, then don't. Look, I won't keep you long. I need to ask a favor. That's not true. I've called plenty of times when there's been nothing wrong. Well, because I'm not a letter writer, and even if I were, this can't wait for the mail. I need to borrow money. Yes, of course I still have my union job. I am business rep for three locals, but no, it doesn't pay very much. If it did, I wouldn't be calling. I never got fired. I got transferred. So don't say again. I never got fired once. I got let go from my second job during the polio scare here. There's a big difference. Look, working for a union does not a rich man make. $200. Look, I'll pay you back as soon. No, I'm not in trouble. When's the last time I ever asked you for money, huh? But never. This is the first time. Yes. Very important. Thank you. Very much.
Caroline's making a sap out of you, Mark.
Like she made a sap out of you?
Well, little man, you could learn from my mistakes. Now, all she wants is to take advantage of you.
Here's some news hot off the wire, Charlie. I want to be taken advantage of. This is not the script we rehearsed.
Well, it's essentially the same.
I only have one line.
Well, I believe you're mistaken. I believe that you have three lines.
I have the same line three times.
Well, that's what we call writing to your strengths. It's one of the advantages of being part of a troupe such as we have on the Lemon Tomato Juice Hour. The writers adjust the scripts in order to play to your strengths. There you are.
Well, if it isn't our rookie apple knocker, Jeff Metcalf. Fancy meeting you here, Jeff.
Oh, I'll say.
Say, how about the weather we've been having lately? It certainly has been cold, and I mean to say cold.
Well, I'll say.
I don't know about you, Jeff, but I'm looking forward to spring when those Lemo tomato seeds are planted to grow the best tomatoes money can buy. And wait, don't tell me, I know what you're going to say. It's a good thing that Lemo tomato juice is fresh even in winter, because if this cold spell lasts much longer, we'll be marching in the Easter parade right on top of Lake Erie.
Well, I'll say.
Why they leave her up there to sing and not him? It's his housewives, not the men who buy their silly tomato juice. Shush yourself. Does your husband do the grocery shopping? Of course not. Neither does mine. And I don't know about you ladies, but I want to dream about Jeff Metcalf, not her. And I don't know about the rest of you ladies, but I can't dream about my dreamboat. There's another woman holding the oars. Here it is, Jeff. Bungalow 5. Oh, you were wonderful on stage tonight.
I'll say.
The audience loved you.
Oh, I'll say.
I'm telling the truth, I assure you.
Well, I guess I can't blame the writers for what they did until I get over my stage fright.
You already know my theory on how to get rid of stage fright.
As I recall, your theory starts, something like this. Halfway expect this motor cord to fall down on top of us.
Why would you expect that?
Because the first time we were about to hit some tension, the train stopped because of that cow on the track. The second time, my brakes slipped, and we did $200 damage to two cars. And the third time, your apartment caught on fire.
Maybe those were signs saying we shouldn't do this.
Maybe, but I find it very frustrating ever to know for certain. Wouldn't you?
I'll say.
Good evening.
Good evening,
though.
Hi.
Hi,
hello.
Well,
good evening.
Welcome. Welcome.
Let me take a coat, Mr. Haley.
Oh, she's gotten so heavy.
She's grown every day bigger.
Oh,
so how's Robert taking it to college?
Two
he seems to be liking
week.
It pretty well.
Will
you tell
pounds,
him? Shall we sit down for supper?
Have something for Emma to begin with?
I will.
Yes. Good. Misty, come on.
Well, shall we?
Yes, ma'am.
Would you come like on, to yeah. come in this way for supper?
Come on.
Like this way.
Yes. Oh. Oh, everything is lovely.
Thank you.
It didn't break. It didn't break.
There's a bit of luck.
Well, if it isn't our rookie apple knocker, Jeff Metcalf.
Fancy meeting you here, Ginger. How about this weather we've been having lately? Is it cold enough for you?
I'll say. When it gets this cold, I find any old excuse to stay inside where it's comfy cozy.
Well, heck, Ginger. Anytime, any place I can put my arm around a pretty gal like you or any of these lovely ladies here in the studio audience. But I'm about as comfy cozy as a man can be no matter how cold the weather.
Well, I can understand that, because when you put your arm around me, I completely forget it's winter.
Well, I guess it's the same with lemon tomato juice. Every time I have a glass of lemon tomato juice, why, it seems like summertime. Because lemon tomato juice uses only the freshest tomatoes, so it always tastes like it's fresh off the vine.
I'll say.
It's swell of you guys to have us over for supper and everything.
Yes.
The pleasure is entirely ours.
Heavens, yes. We've been meaning to do it for quite some time now.
Ever since you announced your engagement, in fact.
Yes, we've been remiss. We hope to make it up to you. A marriage to last a lifetime has to get off on the right foot. And we want nothing more than for your marriage to last a lifetime.
That's nice of you to say so. You've made us, you've made me feel so comfortable and welcome, and I'm starting to have second thoughts about leaving.
Leaving?
Charlie decided to take the job in California.
You have?
Like you say, Mr. S., an opportunity like this doesn't come knocking every day.
Well, I should say not.
And I am going with him.
Well,
only after we are married, of course.
Yep, I sent off to Los Angeles Chamber of Commerce for information on housing.
We would like to see, if possible, if we can get a house with an extra room for you to stay in when you come to visit Emma.
I knew we should never have been nice to him. Be nice to people like that hooligan always backfires.
Everything we do backfires. We tried to replace the Davises and ended up having to give them a raise. We tried to scare Charlie off by disinheriting her, and they both decided it was a good idea. I'll tell you something, Ruth. The world is no longer logical.
I can't bring myself to do this.
Of course you can. Because the alternative will result in your only grandchild living 2,000 miles away, sitting under some godforsaken avocado tree.
You were terrific out there.
Thanks.
No, I mean it, Jeff. You were really terrific.
Thanks.
You're natural. No stage fright. I guess the rehearsals were worthwhile.
The rehearsals must have helped relieve all that tension.
Hey, you were aces tonight, Slugger. Of course, it helps when you're working with the best in the business.
But Ginger was swell, as always.
Thanks. Well.
So, good night, all.
Good night.
Night. Good night.
Should we rehearse the next one?
Oh, sure. He doesn't need more rehearsal.
Come on, Jeff. We'll be late.
It gives me the willies. How nice these people are to me all of a sudden.
You're not to be suspecting. Eventually, the Sloans have come to like you. This should make you happy.
It's not so terrible.
Well, here we are. I hope we haven't kept you waiting too long.
Sorry. Lucky again.
Now listen, you two. Ruth has a proposal.
No, Michael, you tell them.
Oh, go ahead, Ruth.
You.
Go ahead, Ruth.
No, Michael, you.
So be it. Well, I'll start. In our plant, we pride ourselves in our ability to recognize a good worker. And a good worker is not a dime a dozen. When such a person shows up, we are loath to let them get away. Now, Mr. Haley, Charlie, you fall into the category of such a worker, and we don't want to lose you.
Well, that's very kind of you to say, Mr. Sloan. But this is a job opportunity I can't pass up. I mean, the salary alone...
We'll match the salary. And perhaps talk about, perhaps, more responsibilities. The long and the short of it is, we want you, both of you, to stay here in River Run.
I'm flabbergasted. Thank you, sir. I'm sorry.
It's our duty, sir, to soften the blow. Blame it on the network.
Oh, Balderdash, she's not a child. Come in.
Oh. Oh, here they are, the autographed photos you asked for last week. 200 copies. My wrist is about ready to fall off. Thank you very much. I'll put these in the mailroom. Miss Westcott said you wanted to see me?
Yes. Well, the long and the short of it is that we're making some changes in the limo tomato juice.
Oh, I have had some great ideas.
One change in particular. In fact, when you get right down to it, only one change, which is you. I'm giving you notice.
You're firing me?
Well, with a full week's severance.
Why?
I could lie to you, but the truth is we're having budget problems and we need to trim the cast.
There are only two people in the tomato juice skit.
Well, you know, with the departure of one or the other of you, that represents a 50% reduction. And, well, unfortunately for you, the good people at Lambert Tomato Juice worry that housewives, who are actually the people who buy the product, are beginning to see you as the competition. That's show business.
He's lying. I know he's lying. There's got to be some other reason. Jeff isn't even featured on the label. And if the budget is so tight, why don't they fire one of the writers? Or do you think it was somebody at the network that wanted to dump me?
Take it from me, whoever it was doesn't know beans about beans. And this is not the end of the world.
No, it is the end of my world.
No.
I don't want to come back here. I used to work here, did you know that? I ran the place whenever Mr. Brandstater was gone. I made the coffee, I made the sundaes and the sodas. I stocked the shelves, I took inventory, I totaled the receipts.
I bet you were great. You're great at everything you do.
Except what I want to do.
Now, don't be so hard on yourself. I know how talented you are. Anybody with two eyes can see how talented you are.
What a sweet of you to say.
It's the truth.
I don't want to work here again.
Ginger, you never have to work again at all if you don't want to. I'll support you. Ginger, I will take care of you for life. I want to. Please.
Hey, you're back. How was therapy?
Harder on Linda than on me.
The nurse swears with enough training I'll be able to help Mother at home. I told her I need training in patience.
Oh. I have a session at the hospital and a session at home every day.
They hope she'll progress twice as fast that way.
So I should be ready to polka when?
Polka? I couldn't even polka before I had polio.
You never know, Mother, the rate you're going. Show them. She's all yours.
Ain't it the truth?
You seem a lot less tense than usual.
I'm pretty much over my stage fright, too. Why do you say that?
Because you seem a lot less tense than usual.
Hmm.
Have you been out with Mrs. Haley lately?
Yes. It's funny you should ask. It's given me something of a puzzle.
No puzzle about what happened to your tension.
That's very funny.
What's the puzzle?
But Judy, you know my father's dead.
I do, and I'm sorry.
Well, thanks. I only say that to help explain why I would bring up a certain subject. With my father gone and my older brother in Chicago, that only leaves my mom and Linda at home. And there are certain things a fellow doesn't discuss with his mom or his sister. Of course, there's always my mom's new husband, Al, but he and I don't talk much. So I was wondering if you could... Could you not think like a woman for a few minutes and just act like a bartender?
Don't tell me, Slugger. I know what you're going to say.
No, you don't.
Try this. You have a good time when you go out with Mrs. Haley. Judging by how tense you've been in the past, you've been looking forward to having a good time with Mrs. Haley or whoever for a long time. Maybe days, maybe weeks, maybe months. The prospect of having a good time with Mrs. Haley is something you've been thinking about for so long, maybe it erased all other thoughts from your brain.
Never mind.
And then when your dream came true, it was, surely enough, a dream come true. But it wasn't what you expected.
Thanks, I appreciate all the advice.
So you're standing there wondering why the earth didn't move, why things weren't as wonderful as they could have been or might have been in your imagination or on other occasion, the details of which are best left unspoken. You're not the first person to be puzzled by this phenomenon, and it isn't caused by little green men from outer space, and it isn't, I presume, caused by a lack of aptitude, as you so proudly told me once.
You know how to embarrass a fellow, and you enjoy it, don't you?
Don't think of me as a woman. Think of me as a bartender who has the answer. At least the answer some people believe. The earth moves only if you're in love. I'm not saying I subscribe to that theory, though I'm willing to admit some things are better if you're in love. But whether the theory is true or not, what it means in practice is you're not in love with Mrs. Haley. You're still in love with someone else, whether you want to admit it or not. And that's why I never, ever date a man who's on the rebound. A man who's on the rebound does not know his own mind. Is that the gist of the puzzle, Slugger?
Dear Dad, don't faint, but yes, your son is actually writing you a letter. The modern telephone has not yet killed the art. And I won't be spending money on phone calls until I have repaid the money you sent, which I will do as soon as I can. For what the money has done, I can never repay you.
Since graduation, I've been bridesmaid 11 times. How often have you?
I didn't keep count.
Count.
7? 8? This is not cheering me up.
They always say, ask Ginger to be maid of honor. Ask Ginger to host the shower. Ask Ginger. She's always available. I'm tired of it. Mary Beth has 2 kids already. Claire Troha has 3. And Peggy's oldest is starting kindergarten next year, and they put money down on a house. I'm here. I am 25, and pretty soon it'll be too late for me to have kids. I'd like another Sunday, please. Would you like another Sunday? It's my treat. 2 more Sundays, please.
This is not a good idea.
Heavens to Betsy, son, first you complain about not having enough lines, now you complain about having too many.
This is more than too many. They gave me all the lines.
Well, you did just a fine job overcoming your stage fright.
Never mind that. What about Ginger?
Well, the sponsor, the network, the network sponsor, they didn't, she didn't, they felt they didn't want to continue. And also the budget couldn't accommodate such a large cast. And also the writers were in full agreement that the knowledge that the weight of the story was such that the elimination of her character was in the best interest of the show.
You fired her?
Yes.
You can't fire her. She needs the work.
Jeff, this is a rare opportunity. The audience loves you. Look at the kind of mail I've been getting. Look here. The young ball player, and so on and so on, is certainly a breath of fresh air. He is wholesome and sweet, polite and funny, too. He gives a good name to your product, and so on. This is from Mrs. Ann Kahn, and there are many more like it. I've been in this business a long time. You don't get fan mail like this every day of the week.
Mr. Mellon, I have no illusion that I know the radio business better than you do. But I do know that I won't go on the air without Ginger.
Oh, of course you will.
Not unless you rehire her. I won't.
Let's not be hasty.
And don't tell her I insisted on it, because she might not come back if she finds out I had anything to do with it. She's got her pride.
You have a contract, young man.
Tell her the public demanded that you bring her back.
You breach that contract and I'll see to it you never work in show business again.
Mr. Mellon, sir, I don't want to work in show business. I never have.
I made a list, and Arthur is the perfect husband by any and all standards. He's kind. He loves me madly, and that is not a word I use lightly. He's already well off, and he's going to make a lot more money. All attorneys are rich. I'm not getting any younger. And how often does a gal find a guy who thinks she hung the moon? Not very often, as we both know. Sorry. And having a career is not all it's cracked up to be. I'm old enough now to realize that stability is more important than chemistry. And Arthur's stable. And he's good looking. He's polite. And he never embarrasses you in public. He adores me.
It's obvious he's head over heels in love with you. And that counts for a lot.
Well, it does.
Miss Zabel, that's a call for you from the radio station.
I have done some pretty stupid things in my life, but the stupidest, the most stupid was breaking up with you. If you just give me another chance, I...
2 minutes, Mr. Metcalf.
Thank you, Miss Westcott. Wish me luck.
Oh, you don't need luck anymore, Mr. Metcalf.
Oh, yes, I do, especially tonight. It's going to be something special for Ginger and me.
Oh, it's already special for Miss Zabo.
Why do you say that?
Didn't you hear? She's gotten engaged to Arthur Schillip. Time, Mr. Metcalf.